Hi, this is Remy again from Case at JMU. And in this video, we are going to unpack your kit that you received to start prepping your team for a KidWind challenge. So this is the default kit that people are going to receive. This one does not have the PVC turbine in it, nor does it have any blade materials in it. So we're not going to unpack this one in particular, but just know that it's the same as this, except you won't have the PVC or the blade materials in it. Let's talk about what's in the kit. So when you receive your starter kit, you're going to have a multimeter with some alligator clips. And this is so that you can measure the output from your generator. So this is the key for the wind competition, is the KidWind generator. In order to be able to harness energy from the wind using this generator, you need to be able to attach the hub to the generator and then blades to the hub. And so that's what the dowels are for. So the dowels in the hub are going to allow you to catch that kinetic energy in the wind, transfer it to the wind turbine or the generator, and then the generator hooked to the multimeter will tell you what you're getting. The last piece that's in your kit is what we call a pitch protractor. And once we've got everything set up, I can show you how to use the pitch protractor. This will help you set the angle of the blades once you start constructing blades. If you have the default kit, you do not have the PVC, but you were given a cut sheet that will tell you how to go out and buy a 5-foot piece of PVC, cut it into these pieces, and the couplers that you're gonna need in order to build this. The first thing you're gonna need is you're going to have this tall piece of PVC, roughly 22 inches. You're gonna have six inch pieces of PVC. This is a straight coupler with like a 2-inch piece of PVC, all right? Then you're gonna have 4 elbows and 4 T's. And then all of this is gonna come together and it's gonna be fabulous. All right, we're ready? So the first thing I would do is construct the base. And so for the base, you're going to insert 2 6-inch pieces into each of the three of the T's. Okay, so now this is going to get turned into an H. So you've got your two pieces on one side, and then one is gonna stick up in the middle. And that's where your tower is gonna go. Okay. You can finish it there if you want, but I like to add the elbows as feet for my tower. It also helps it to be a little bit stable. There we go. Okay. And that leaves the last piece, which is what we will call the nacelle. So this is where we're gonna insert the generator. So you've got your coupler with your small little PVC piece attached to an elbow. Okay. And then that is gonna pop onto the top of your tower. So there you have your PVC tower. The next thing you have to do is you have to install the generator. Okay. So these are the KidWind generators. There's, if you buy like one of the kits from Vernier, you're gonna get two different generators. The other one's gonna be a little bit skinnier and a little bit longer. And that is a high torque generator that puts you in the open division. Don't use that. If you're starting out, make sure you're using the KidWind, the fat and thin kind of generator. So the first thing you'll do is you're gonna run the wires straight through. So you want the generator to sit right here. So you're gonna drop the wires in and they're gonna go all the way through to the back. Ta-da! Okay, fantastic. And now you can hook it to the generator and measure the output. But the key here, the one last thing you want to do is this thing is really loose in there. So if you have some electrical tape, you can use pretty much any tape you want. But if you wrap it a couple of times around that generator, it is going to give it a little bit more diameter and it's going to stick better into that PVC coupler. And so You may have to do it a couple of different times to get it to fit, but it's gonna fit a little bit more snug. So that way, every time you take your blades on and off, it doesn't pop out. Okay, so this is the basic setup. The next thing that we're gonna need to do is we need to build some blades to put onto the wind turbine. Okay, so this is your hub. This is what we call a 12-hole crimping hub. It's a little bit confusing to use, but I'll walk you through it. So you're just gonna untwist it a couple of twists, and then it should pop open. So there's just a little bit of a crack. Once you have it popped open, you're able to stick your wooden dowels in. Okay. If you need to unscrew it a little bit more to get some more room in there, you're gonna hear them kind of click into place because there are grooves in there. And then you're gonna tighten it up, just finger tight. They're not gonna come out, they're not gonna fly out. And at this point, the little hole on the very back is gonna match up to the shaft on the generator, and you're gonna be able to pop it onto your turbine. And so when this turns, you're gonna hot glue blade designs onto these dowels. And like I said, some of you will have blade materials. Otherwise, I highly recommend some, you know, old Amazon boxes, old poster boards, anything you can find in the recycling is perfect for blades. And at the competition, remember that they do give you points based on innovation and selection of materials. So recycled materials get you a couple extra points there. But you can hot glue those right onto these dowels. And then when they catch the wind, the generator will spin and we'll be able to measure the output using this multimeter. Okay. And I'll show you real quick how we can measure the output using your multimeter. And then I think you'll have everything you need to be well on your way to making your own turbine and having your kids start experimenting with lots of different blade designs. All right, so when you set up your multimeter, the black lead is gonna go in the bottom hole, and then the red lead is gonna go right above it in the second hole, okay? Make sure you push them down so they're nice and tight in there. You're gonna connect your red lead from the multimeter to the red wire coming out of your generator using the alligator clips in your kit. They're not always gonna be red and black alligator clips, so just as long as you connect red to red and black to black, doesn't matter which color the alligator clip is. And make sure you're connecting it to the metal on your generator and not the plastic, okay? And then we're gonna set this, these are direct current generators. So we need to use the V with the line and the dotted line that represents direct current. And then we're gonna set the multimeter to 20. And when you spin the generator, and again, if you had blades on here and had it in front of a fan, it would do this on its own. And it probably wouldn't fall off like that. And the last thing that I'll show you is how you can use this pitch protractor to make sure that the angle of your blades is consistent. Okay, so you're gonna take your hub off of the generator and hold it in the palm of your hand with the dot facing down, the hole facing down, and the screw part facing up. All right, so if you had a blade on here, you would take the pitch protractor, and on the back there's this little groove, and it allows it to set right on the hub just like that, and it's perfectly level with the hub now. And you can use that, and you'll just look down. If you had a blade on here, the blade would tell you what angle it's set at, and you can adjust them. If you just untighten the screw just a tad, you can just move your dowels a tad so that you can get it to the angle that you want. And then you just lift it up and change to the next blade. And now you can just make sure all of your blades are at the same consistent angle. And of course you can do experiments on different pitch angles to figure out what's the optimal blade angle. But it's a real important tool to have, and hopefully it is a helpful piece of your kit. If you have questions about how to go further, you can contact me at casejmu@gmail.com or look for more videos on how we'll advance with a gearbox added to the turbine and other advancements that you can look into.